all day long, so I'm really loud. No, I don't yell. I love that. Pretty loud. Okay. that's me. I don't know if you need to know anything else about me, but I'm Dr. Jensen. I go by Dr. Jensen. Or Dr. J, for whatever reason. Jensen's really hard, and a lot of people call me that. So I respond to either, so that's fine. Don't call me JJ. That's the one that just bugs me. All right, so let's actually have our TAs introduce themselves and answer those questions, because they are your first tool for success in this class. So we have two lecture TAs. So I'm going to start with you, Bryant. Just stand up and introduce yourself and answer those questions.
Hi, everyone. My name is Bryant.
Hi, Bryant.
Hello.
So educational plans right now. I am applying to medical school, so I'm in the middle of that process. Sweet. Hobbies. I like all sports. I like to have art and I just don't run off. In the summer, I actually took a team to Guatemala and we worked at medical clinics there. That was a lot of fun.
And are you better?
What's that?
Are you all better?
Yes, I got a little bit sick.
And then
I'm going to make everyone like it a crick in their neck. I'm Dallin. Right now, I am actually studying mechanical engineering. Don't ask me why I'm TAing this class. Dr. Jensen is very nice to me. Hobbies, anything outside. I play rugby. I played rugby a long time ago. Hiking, swimming, snowboarding. And the craziest thing I ever did, the stupidest thing I've ever did, was try to drive across the Nevada desert without AC. That sucks. Yeah. You guys all see folks been suffering that lately. But yeah, that's me.
Right. Okay, so, and you have other TAs. I think I have a slide. Yes, I do. So sorry, Brent, that's unfortunate. Fine. Anyway, your TAs, so all of you should be in the lab section, and you should have attended it already if you were Tuesday. Yes? And if you were Monday, you should have received a video welcome from Austin or Bridger. Yes? Does anybody have questions about that? Like, oh, I can go to lab, or what's lab? Flesh, did you not know?
I didn't get a video.
Are you on Monday?
Yeah.
Okay, so I know he sent it out, so you need to look like junk mail or.
Okay.
But email me if you don't get it, and I will track it down and send it to you. I didn't even see it, so I have to get it. But you should have got one because those of you who are on a Monday, obviously Monday was Labor Day, and so there was no lab, and so technically we should require you to have any responsibilities. However, later in the semester, when it's a Monday before Thanksgiving, you don't have to go to lab. So that's cool. So we're giving, we figured we'd just start at the beginning and then give you that break on the Thanksgiving week. Because Tuesday's a Friday of that week, so Tuesday labs don't happen. So Monday labs don't happen either. Anyway, so that's, yeah, so if you haven't received that video or you didn't attend lab, you need to email your lab TA. Does anybody know who your lab TA is? You should have met them. I don't know which is which. I mean, as far as which lab. I know that Austin and Bridger are on Mondays, and the rest are on Tuesdays. Yeah, so you'll meet them, hopefully, by video. The rest you should have met them yesterday. Yeah. Okay, so the way this class works is you're going to see these folks first for all the new material, and we'll talk about why in a minute, but all the new material, you're going to see them first in lab, and then we will talk about it in lecture Wednesday, Friday, Monday, and then you'll learn new stuff in lab, and then we'll talk about it Wednesday, Friday, Monday, and so on, okay? So you'll always see them first before we talk about anything in the class, all right? Okay, so that's your TAs. They're very helpful. The lecture TAs will be here with us in lecture. Lab TAs don't come. So the lecture TAs will know most what's going on as far as in the class. But the tests come from both lab and lecture. So, and the lab TAs are aware of what we're doing in class. I've given them all the instructions and instructor guides, so they should be able to answer your questions. But Brian and Dallin are going to be the foremost experts for what we talk about in lecture. All right, and they will be holding weekly reviews when they figure out when. Yes? Okay.
And location.
So you'll know that, all right? All right, so let's go ahead and do the mirrors first because I want to explain some things about why I teach this class the way I do. So I want you, with your partner, just do directions and get started if you haven't already. Okay?
Thank you.
It's hard to write.
It's just hard to
visualize. It's hard to visualize that, hard to read the words and figure that out. Hard to retrain your brain. Okay. Yeah, so learning in general is exactly this way. Okay, you have to learn things, but sometimes you have to relearn things. And relearning is harder than learning. Okay? And so I think I have a slide. Do not write any of this down. This is just FYI for you. Okay? But there's two ways of learning. There's assimilation and accommodation. So assimilation is when you learn something for the very first time. There's really nothing in your brain about that. And you just put it in there. So the first time you learned to write, you were assimilating. And it's hard. Assimilation is hard, but it's not nearly as hard as accommodation. Accommodation is when you run into something that you thought you knew, and then someone or something is telling you different than what you thought you knew, and you have to change your mental structure to accommodate the new information. Okay, it causes cognitive conflict. It's that uncomfortable feeling that you were all doing as you were writing, and you think, what the heck? Why can't I do this? Because your brain is telling you one thing, and what you're seeing, your eyes were telling you another, and it didn't compute, right? And so you have to rearrange your mental structures. And the only way to do that is to experience it. The only way to do that is for you to experience the cognitive conflict and decide that what you thought all along maybe isn't true. Now, how many of you think you have preconceptions about biology? You've been outside. Okay, all of you have things you think you know that might be a little bit off from what's reality. And so as a consequence, it's my job not to PowerPoint at you. It's my job to help you discover that you're wrong. In a good way. Okay? And accommodate new information. Now sometimes it's going to be assimilation, and hopefully that's easier. But a lot of times it's going to be a combination, because I guarantee you there's a whole handful of you, at least in here, that think that plants use soil, okay, to build mass. And we'll work on that. Okay? We'll work on a lot of them, right? Or you think that if you take antibiotics, it causes mutations in the bacteria that make them resistant. Another one. There's lots. In fact, those are the two that my TAs have to answer when they get a job. These two go away. That's good. Okay, so there's a lot of misconceptions you're going to encounter in the class, and you're going to have to overcome them yourselves, and I can't do it for you. What that means is I do lecture more in here than I do in Bio 100 because the lab is mostly your cognitive conflict area is in the lab, okay? And so there's five modes to instruction. I'm going to write them on the board. I don't really care if you know them, but I will figure out the life. So I use the five E's. In education, we love acronyms and it's ridiculous. Anyway, but this is a good one. This is how you're going to learn in this class. All right, so engagement, we're going to get you excited about something. And then you will explore it. No one should tell you anything until you've had a chance to explore it on your own. Okay? And this all happens in lab. And then the rest of this happens in lecture, but used lightly after. Okay, and then these are tests. Alright? So in lab you'll be presented with a puzzling phenomena. A phenomenon or lots of puzzling phenomena. And you will have to explore it and come up with your own hypotheses, and you're going to be sort of annoyed at first, I guarantee you. You'll be like, why don't you just tell me the answers? That's not good for you. So they're not going to tell you the answers, and you're going to have to struggle through it. But by the end, you should have the answers. And they'll explain a few things. And then you'll come to lecture, and I'll explain it a little more, maybe add in a few more details. And then we will practice applying it to different situations. Because research has also shown that if you learn it in one context, your knowledge becomes contextually specified. That principle only works if we're talking about pre-flex. It does not apply to anything else unless I help you apply it to other things. So we'll do a lot of that in class, and then evaluation. You learned the lab already. You'll take quizzes in there once a week. And then we have exams in there that I'll show you in this one. Okay? So that's kind of the rationale behind this class. All right? That's why. why we teach it the way we do. And what I've found over the many years I've been doing it this way is that usually there's a tiny bit of resistance at the beginning when the student's like, oh my gosh, just tell me. And then you think, oh my gosh, this is so fun. Okay, so just give it, if you're feeling like, oh, I'm frustrated, give it just a second. You'll love it. Promise. And these two can attest, they've been through classes. Yes? Can we show you something else? This is my son. I showed him yesterday that I was using it. He's now 14, but this is. I just want you to listen. So this was morning scripture study. You can tell that my children are never awake during morning scripture study. And we had just read the story of the Good Samaritan, and I asked him to summarize for me the Good Samaritan. Oh, let's see. I hope if it doesn't play volume, I need to just do it really quick. Just one second. Does it default to HDMI? Yes, right.
And all three guys wouldn't help him, and when one came, he took the man and put him in his trunk and started driving away. And then he woke up in a bed. He was nice and warm, and he had a couple of bruises and cuts, and he felt really bad, but he was glad that the man helped him.
What did he do? He told the story. What did he add to the story?
A truck.
Yeah, a truck. Okay, why did he do that?
Experience.
There was a gap in his understanding, and his brain filled it in. Our brains are really good at doing that, as you can see from the passage on the right. You're really not that young. Almost everybody can do that. But that's because your brain's really good at filling in gaps. It will fill in gaps like crazy. Because it's a survival mechanism. It's our evolution. We do this to survive, put in gaps of experience. But sometimes it's completely ludicrous. There are no trucks. Okay? But that was, how did he get from one place to another? Well, gosh, it must have been a truck. All right? So what does that mean for you? It means that when you're studying for this class and you're rereading your notes in your heads, as you all think is super effective, your brain will fill in gaps that you don't know with nonsense that you will then repeat on the test. It would be nonsense, okay? So I would strongly, strongly, strongly encourage you to study out loud with another person, preferably. You can do it out loud to the wall. But if you say it out loud, your brain will recognize the gaps much better than if you say it just in your head. And research has shown that rereading your notes is just as effective as going out and playing basketball for an hour. The best way to learn information is to teach someone else that information. And so if you form study groups and you teach each other the material, you'll know it better. Or if you pick up parent, boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever, roommate, and you teach them the information, you're going to learn it better too. And hopefully that person you're teaching it to will catch you when you say that there's a truck. Okay? And you will, it's a better way to study. So I think that I have,
and
whoops. Oh, no, you want to do this first. So, if you have a device with you, if you don't, I'm sorry, but you can do it later. I want you to go to our Canvas site, give you a second tool for your success. Okay? I want you to go to the Canvas site, let's just figure out a better way to do this. I look for programs online for form study partners, and there probably is one that I just didn't know, but I figured out, there's a discussion board. You can go to the discussion board, and I put up four different discussions. Like if you're a Monday, Wednesday, Friday morning person versus a Monday, Wednesday, Friday afternoon person, a Thursday morning person versus a Thursday afternoon person. If you're interested in a study group, this is the place where you can connect with other people in this class for study groups. So if you want to take a second to do that, I will just shut up. 12 how to get to the discussions. It's a lot of link right there. If you click on that, you can respond to the discussions somehow. If you go responding, is it working? There we go. So you can reply to the thread depending on when you like to want to study. Is it working for you guys? Okay. And you can do that later too, it will be up there. But I would strongly encourage you to get Partner. Okay. BYU.instructure.com. So BYU now gives the professors the option of using Learning Suite or Canvas. And should I even say Learning Suite? Anyway, I do a lot of education research because that's what my forte is. My whole lab is education research in biology, and I used Learning Suite for a while until it destroyed just about every research project I tried. And so I jumped ship to Canvas and was using their freeware until BYU finally realized they should give us the option. So you can use Canvas. So if you're not familiar with it, it's through BYU. It communicates with AIMS. Anyway, so you go to BYU.instructure.com. Okay. And it brings you to Canvas. Is anyone having trouble getting into Canvas? You running into issues? Anyone? Yes, what's the issue? Oh, she's not loading. Oh, that's. Might be the room. Yeah. It's the first day. Yeah. Okay. But, all right. So, let me walk you through what's here for you on Canvas. So, the first thing is the TA bios. So if you need to know who your TA is, or if you need to go, that was my sample. If you go to here, all of the TA's pictures are there, and their information, where they hold their study sessions. Oh, hey, their lab section is there. That's convenient. All right, so let's go through that really fast. I didn't realize that. So Andrea is the Tuesday 12 to 3. That's your TA if you're Tuesday 12 to 3. If you are Monday 1 to 4, there's Austin. Okay, if you're Monday 4 to 7, there's Bridger. If you are Tuesday 3 to 6, you are Claire. If you are Tuesday 8 to 11, you are Ed. And then Dallin is in the lecture, and Brian's in the lecture. Thanks. But they will put up their weekly review times and locations there. That's, and you know what we should do is actually put an email up there. So Dallin, if you'll update yours and put an email, and yep. Brian, did you list it? Oh, you've got it right here. Oh, he's got it too. Never mind. Do the rest of them have it? I just don't believe. No, I need to tell them. Oh, a couple of them do. Okay. All right, so you can contact them that way. Okay, so that is, and anytime you're in Canvas, it does put a bread trail up here, so you can click back, or you can just always click home. Home will always take you back home. Okay? The link. All right. Next thing is the packet, the student packet. You should have purchased one from the bookstore. You need a hard copy of it in lab. You don't bring it to lecture, just lab, every day. Your homework assignments are in there. Everything's in there, so you need to purchase a hard copy. But if for whatever reason you lose it or you'd rather print it out yourself, it's there. So you don't have to buy it from the bookstore. But honestly, the bookstore is the same price as printing. So they might charge you 50 cents more to sure grab it, but all right. This is your best friend right here, the Bio 130 Learning Outcomes. I strongly encourage you to download these. You can download them, they'll also pull up here. I have painstakingly gone through every day of every week of class, every unit, and told you exactly what you need to be able to do. And when I write exam questions, I look at these and I say, let's see, they need to be able to identify and understand the difference between independent and dependent variable. What can an exam question look like? Here's an experiment. What's the independent and the dependent variable? Okay, if they are that closely aligned. So if you're looking for a study guide, this is it. Tells you what you need to know from the labs, tells you what you need to know from lecture. Occasionally I will modify this, I'll let you know if I do, because sometimes we don't get to something and I'm like, just kidding, I can't test you on that because we never covered it. We will cover everything that will be on the test either in lab or lecture. So I don't like to pull things from the textbook that I haven't said. So you don't need to. Not a quiz show. So, any questions on learning outcomes? And I know that I will meet with several of you after exam one. You'll be like, I don't know how to study. I'm like, well, you looked at learning outcomes and you say the what? I'm just telling you now, please, go find the learning outcomes. They're there. All right. The schedule, I would also strongly recommend you download this. This is exactly what we're covering each day of class. Okay? What the lab is in orange. I'm sorry, I'm really into crazy colored Excel sheets. And people make fun of me, I know, because I'm always like, what the heck is that? I'm sorry. That makes sense in my head, so it doesn't to you, I'm sorry. The exams, this is what the exam covers. So see where it cuts off right there? That means it's going to cover everything up through right there. And there's the dates. And they force us to put a late date on exams, just so you know, the payday. Because, and I didn't know this as a student, I wish someone had told me, the testing center is like independent of BYU. I mean, they're BYU people, but they're independent and they charge us, the faculty, the departments, to put tests in there. And so by doing the late day, enough of you students slack off to the last day that it usually pays the cost of administrative. So that's why they force us to do a late day. The departments force us to do a late day. Anyway, okay, so that's what the exams are. And then we're going to talk about the study skills strategies. I have put together a really cool set of videos from a cognitive psychologist that talk about how you should study appropriately. I know a lot of you are freshmen. This is going to be so good for you to help you be metacognitive about your learning. And so I'm requiring you to complete these study modules. The first one needs to be done by the 15th, which is next week, okay, by 11:59 p.m. It's online. I'll show you where. You're just going to watch the little videos and learn how to study better. And then after each exam, it's going to like, you're going to do it again and say, huh, did I do as well as I thought I would? Why not? What should I do better? What can I change? That kind of thing. Okay? So that's on there. This is the writing. You will write a paper in here. Your Inner Fish is the book you're reading. And then you're going to write a book review. And these are the milestones for that, because you're going to post on the discussion board. You're going to blog about it. And you get points for that. Okay? And so these are your markers. So you should have chapter 4 finished by the 25th of September. So get reading. It's an awesome book. And Neil is amazing. I've met him. He's the coolest guy ever. I met him over video conference. He was sitting on the Antarctic continent doing cool stuff. And then this is the lecture homework. So you always have a homework assignment to in lab. You guys all know that from your lab intro. There's always a homework assignment due in lab. There are occasionally lecture assignments, like you're going to build posters of photosynthesis and cellular respiration and explain to people on campus. It's really fun. Okay, and those are due dates there. Okay, so that's the schedule. Any questions about that? Yeah?
So you'll assign something and then we'll do it in the lab, but there's also assignments from the lectures.
Mm-hmm. Occasional ones. There's not a lot, but yeah. Yeah.
Is there a textbook reading guide that goes along with this?
Yes. Did I not put it here? I will have one up there. Thank you for reminding me. Write it down in the book. Thank you. I forgot to put the computer in it, just realized. Not that it's going to die, but. Okay, so I will get one up there for you. Thank you. So, Mastering Biology. If you bought a new textbook, you got access to Mastering Biology. If you chose not to, you will not have access. Let me tell you what we use Mastering Biology for. I use it for this practice evaluation. So there will be days in class where we spend a good portion of the class period on Mastering Biology, like answering cool questions and their application stuff. So if someone around you has Mastering, you can do it with them, but you're going to sort of be like sitting there thinking, oh, crap, I don't know anything to do. So I would strongly recommend you get access to Mastering. It's also a great study tool. There are all kinds of self-quizzes and videos and all kinds of stuff to help you with the material. So we will use that in class. So I'm requiring it, but obviously I didn't require you by anything. So, but I would like that if you have Mastered Biology. There are no points associated with it though. So you will not suffer in your grade because you will not suffer in points because you don't have Mastering. You might not learn some of the information if you don't have Mastering. But you won't suffer points-wise, okay? All right, the first lecture assignment, it is here right now, it is due by the 15th. It is a pretest on your scientific thinking skills. It doesn't matter what score you get, just that you try. There's algorithms we figure out you're guessing, especially if you go deep all the way down. Okay, so please just do your best, but don't look at outside information and don't study. It should take you 30 minutes, maybe, to complete. Let's do by the 15th. The rest of them are on here. Lecture TA class notes. If I write write anything on the board, one of these two will take a picture of it and they will post it under the lecture notes or if there's any important information. If there's any PowerPoints that I use, I will post them there as well. So if you miss a day of class, you can just go there and find information, all right? It's certainly not, I always get complaints, it's not as good as if I was there. I'm like, yeah, duh. I'm not like, I don't videotape. I'm only videotaping today because a lot of people will add this class for the next week or so. And I don't have to just say everything I just said. So, but normally we don't videotape. All right, am I missing anything? Any questions? Yeah.
Where do we access the survey?
That scientific
study
reasoning?
Skills, yeah.
So it should be in this
yeah.
link.
Okay.
Yep, so it's working. So you're just gonna take, it's on Qualtrics. By the way, this survey, because it's on Qualtrics, if you like start doing it and then you stop and you walk away for a while, if you go back to the same computer, it may save it, but it may not. So it'd be nice if you just did it in one sitting. All right, and make sure you give your name or you don't get credit. The study skills that I was gonna show you. So those study skills that I was talking about, that's the other assignment. They are right here. So that first survey is due on the 15th, and you're gonna click on it and do it the same way. It'll take you to Qualtrics. And you'll watch the little videos and do it there, okay? Notice here, there is a practice exam. If you want to get a feel for my exam style, I put one up there. And an answer key, so try it first and then grade yourself. But it's information that we will learn in the first unit, so you might try it a little later.
Is that a practice exam only for the first exam?
Yeah, it's just for the first unit. It's just to show you what the type of exam questions I ask.
Is
it
for example those for every
exam? No. I find that students get shocked by the first one, and then the second and third, go, oh, I don't want to test. Like, big blown problems where you're solving the world's problems. Yeah. So, okay, other questions? These are good questions. Yes, sorry.
For the writing that's due on Mondays, the one that's due on the 9/25.
Yes.
Is that, so we read obviously chapter 1 through 4 in the textbook.
Yes.
Right.
And then you blog on the discussion board. So if you go here to this part, this I'm still on the homepage, you're under FISH. So the review guidelines are right here, and it will give you all the instructions. This is what you will do eventually, right? But your library lab is part of it. That's what you're doing this week is library lab. And then you're going to read chapters 1 through 4. Oh, dang it, I forgot to change the dates on the review. Ignore these dates. Can you write that down too? Thank you. So you're gonna post one original post and at least two comments on someone else's post. And you'll get 6 points for the three points that you make. Okay? And then we usually do a real quick write in class. So you're just gonna post like, oh, that was really cool, blah, 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 blah. And then you'll go to someone else's post and comment on theirs. And as long as we count the three comments and they're not just, yeah, ditto. I like that. That is a word. We want critical thinking on this. Okay? And so you can see what's required of you throughout, and then we'll put in a first draft, and we'll peer review it, and we'll do a final draft. All right? Yeah, and I'll remind you of upcoming deadlines all the time. I'll always have announcements up there that say, this is coming! Beware. Yeah. All right? Anything else? Good question. So how, she asked, how long do the tests take? They're usually, my tests are a mix of multiple choice, fill in the blank, and drawing slash essay type questions. Students generally, I would say on average, spend about an hour and a half taking them. They're in the testing center, so you can take as long as you need to take, unless you go for supposed time. Yeah, so I would give yourself a solid 3 hours just in case. But and there are about 50-ish questions. And your quizzes in lab are different, right? Those are just that 10 questions right at the beginning of lab if you're late with this one. Okay. Anything else? You're in lab or anything questions about your lab? Yeah.
So the lab quizzes every week.
Yeah, the lab quizzes are every week, so you'll go in the lab, the first thing you'll do is take a quiz. It's mostly over lab material, but it can include things we've covered in lecture. It's mostly lab material. And then, what's that?
Are you writing something?
Yes, I wrote it. Yeah, so you'll take the lab quiz, and then you'll do the lab, and then there's a homework assignment associated with the lab. You have to attempt the homework before you come to class on Wednesday. Okay? So you must attempt that homework assignment before Wednesday and get a signature on it, an initials. Most of the time, the labs do not take the full 3 hours. Almost always, right? I mean, they're not. Okay. So most of the time, they don't take the full 3 hours, so you'll have time at the end of lab to attempt and get your TA signature. If you didn't have time, you had to go, whatever, you went home, you attempted at home. An attempt means a serious attempt, not smiley face, I don't know this one, smiley face, I love this, I don't know this one, that's not a serious attempt. You bring it in on Wednesday, and both Dallin and Bryant will initial them for you. Yeah, that's, you get an automatic 5 points on your homework for just trying. And then you get an additional 10 for correctness the following lab return. So each homework assignment are 15 points, but it's free 5 if you just try it. Question?
So you said the like textbook reading
yes, I will
guide will not be up by later today or
probably not.
Okay.
All the way till 3 week meetings, but it will be up soon. Hopefully by tomorrow.
So that's
a good question. This is how I suggest you use the textbook. I don't think you should read before you come to class. I know it's weird, but I study this, right? And what I found is if you read before class, you might get a little bit out of it, but a lot of it is like Greek, and you're not really sure what it's talking about. So I prefer if you go to lab and you come to lecture and you get exposed to the material, and then you go read after. Because when you read after, you're like, oh yeah, this looks familiar, and it will fill in holes. So I prefer you read after. So I will put on there, you know, these are the chapters we're covering for this week. I thought I had it on there, but I must have erased it. So these are the chapters we're covering this week. I will read them after. Yeah.
And if anyone's missing a textbook, I still have a textbook from when I took the class that I need to get rid of. So just come talk to me if you're still short a textbook, or the Inner Fish as well. Because I have 2 copies of that, and I'm willing to get rid of one.
Fantastic. So you need to buy it. Yeah, so I'll try to get up those readings as soon as possible. I know I have them somewhere because I had them and then they disappeared. So I'll get those up. Anything else? Okay. Oh, I have office hours Wednesdays 1 to 3, except today. Because I didn't decide on my office hours after I got those readings. But otherwise, I'm not. All right, so I need the mirrors back in the box, but also hand them to one of the kids.